This is a change of pace from our last outing.
Don't remind me. The thought of that tent still makes my blood boil. I've been thinking about those poor dragons in the fighting ring. The collars they were wearing, they appeared to be goblin silver. I think a collar is precisely what we found at that poacher camp. I've never known poachers to use anything like that before.
The dragon that attacked my carriage was wearing a collar, and Professor Fig was genuinely baffled by its behavior.
That attack always did strike me as a little strange, seemingly coming out of nowhere. Surely you aren't suggesting that the collars somehow control the poor creatures?
Exactly.
Merlin, I don't think the dragon we set free was wearing a collar, but we should check. And if we can find her, we can return her egg.
That's a good idea. We need to see this through.
I'll start looking into it right away. There was something else that I wanted to discuss with you. I didn't want to press it before. It seems I may have caused you more trouble with Victor Rookwood. Why is he after you?
If it's all right with you, I'd rather not say. At least not at the moment.
Understood. We all have our secrets. I shan't press for more details. In fact, I should probably be going. I'd like to track that dragon down as soon as I can. I'll let you know when I have news of her location.
Hello, Serona. I received your owl. How are you?
Hello, my friend. Did you ever find Lord Gog?
I did, thank you. We had a good conversation. He sends you his best.
Glad to hear it. I shan't ask for details of your little chat, and I'll refrain from telling you to be careful yet again. But I hope you will be, whatever your plans.
Of course. Your owl mentioned you're needing my help with something.
I do. I thought you might be just the person to do a favour for my friend Dorothy Sprottle in Upper Hogsfield.
I don't believe I've met Mrs. Sprottle.
She's lovely. Her late husband, Aidan, was a friend of my father's. In fact, I'd stay with Dot and Aidan the summers I waited tables here as a student. I've seen her a few times since Aidan passed, but the pub's been so busy lately, I've not been as attentive as I'd have liked. I wonder if you might pop in and see her. She may need some help collecting ingredients for her supply of Wiganweld potion. And you could retrieve something of mine in the process. A box, full of old letters and such.
Why does Mrs. Sprottle keep a supply of Wiganweld potion on hand?
Dot's a skilled potioner. She's been supplying travelling vendors with Wiganweld potion. An ordinary precaution that has, unfortunately, become a necessity, what with Ranrock's loyalists disrupting the trade routes.
Why did Mr. and Mrs. Sprottle have your box of letters after all this time?
It's one of a few that I had when I was young. Dot found it when she was clearing out a closet. Can't imagine what's in there. Probably terribly theatrical. The ramblings of a teenage witch and her friends. You're welcome to take a peek inside, if you do find it. To be honest, I'd imagine it contains some lovely memories.
I'll try to go and see her when I can.
It would mean the world to me, and to Dorothy. Aidan was bringing the box of letters to me when he was taken ill. Dot can tell you where he might have dropped it. You'll find the hamlet just north of Hogsmeade. Please do give Dot my love.
Ravenia.
lived here, I wonder? Upper Hogsfield. Now, where to find Mrs. Sprottle? It's like a place right...
Bardo Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by dark wizards he was.
Hello, Mrs. Sprottle. Actually, Serona Ryan asked if I'd come and see you.
Oh! Dear Serona, a gem, has been for as long as I've known her.
She thought you might need help collecting ingredients for your Wiganweld potion.
And she's correct. My darling Aiden used to collect hawk lumps for me. Since he died, my supply has dwindled.
I'm sorry for your loss, Mrs. Sprottle.
Oh, thank you. Love of my life. A bit lost without him. If you wouldn't mind gathering some hawk lumps for me, I'd be happy to compensate you for your time.
Believe it or not, I have some with me.
Oh, thank you! How wonderful! The travelling vendors will be thrilled to replenish their stock of Wiganweld potion.
Serona also mentioned that Mr. Sprottle was bringing her a box of letters when he fell ill.
Indeed he was! I'd almost forgotten. I stumbled upon it just before Aiden died. He was hoping to go through it with Serona over a butterbeer or two. Those two were always like two bow truckles in a branch. Aiden took ill when he was collecting hawk lumps on his way to see her. He made it home, but I fear he dropped the box in the cavern. The cavern is in the hills just southwest of our hamlet. You can gather hawk lumps and collect the box of letters there.
Serona said she lived with you during the summers when she was at Hogwarts. What was she like?
Oh, goodness. Well, she was almost exactly like she is now. Charming, good head on her shoulders, taking care of everyone. I can't tell you the fun we had when she and her friends would visit us during the year, all buzzing about, practicing charms. Talented group. Her friend Mirabelle was a genius in the garden. Learned it all from her muggle parents, if you can believe it.
Do you remember anything about the letters you put in the box?
Oh, of course. A few letters from some of her school friends. Some nice memories. I even included a letter Serona had written to me when she was staying with us. Thought she might enjoy reading it. I know when I read writing from my youth, I'm always astonished at how much I've changed, and yet remain the same.
Thank you, Mrs. Sprottle.
Thank you. I'll be here if you are able to collect those hawk lumps. I, and the vendors I help, would greatly appreciate it.
These rocks have seen better days.
Enjoy stealing Hippogriffs, do you? I shall...
This must be the cavern Mrs. Sprottle mentioned.
You're the little son of St. Treadwell. admirable trick.
To Mrs. Sprottle, but I still need to visit the cave to find Serona's box of letters. Perhaps I'll find more Horcrumps while I'm there. Better have a look around, see if I can find that box of letters.
Confringo!
Ah, that's all the Horcrumps for now. Mrs. Sprottle should be pleased. Either I'll have to fight that troll, or avoid it altogether.
Confringo!
Poison! think that's everything. Sorin will be glad to have this back. I should take this box of letters to Sorona. She'll be glad to have it back.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Hello, Sorona. I have good news. I was able to provide your friend Mrs. Sprottle with some Horcrumbs for her Wiganweld potion, and I found your box of letters.
Oh, thank you. I knew you were the one to ask.
I'm glad I could be of help. Mrs. Sprottle sends her best.
Don't know what I'd have done without her and Aiden. Thank you, again, for helping her. And for returning this box of letters. It's nice to reflect on good memories.